Hey, what's up, YouTube? Welcome to Sixx Days. I am Bob Sixx, and today this episode is based on a true story. You know, kind of like the biopics that are really popular right now, and even though they're doing really well, they're very entertaining, they're great movies. You know, Bohemian Rhapsody, The Dirt. Oh, love The Dirt. I've done reviews on them. I've done 3 videos on The Dirt. But I think a lot of people are confusing biopics with documentaries. Documentary is supposed to be all facts or known facts, or it's not for your entertainment. It's to show you how things happen, like, you know, how George Lucas came up with the idea for Star Wars, or how the bicycle was invented, or how Harley Davidson became popular. Those are documentaries. Or I have to say this one because when my wife caught me watching this documentary, she was pissed. And I don't mean like pissed we got in a fight, but I watched a documentary on the world's greatest sushi chef. She asked me if I was planning on becoming a sushi chef. I said no, but this is a fascinating story. That's how nerdy I am. I go through documentaries. In anything, regardless if I care about it or not, catches my eye, I watch. So that's documentaries. Biopics, while they are based on a true story, which it says right at the beginning of most of them, based on a true story, it's not true. It's not a documentary. I mean, not the whole thing's true. It's based on, you know, there's facts in the movie, but it's done for your entertainment. Lots of movies over the years have been based on true stories. For example, the movie Jaws. It's based on the 1916 Jersey Shore shark attacks. Only 4 people were killed. They never caught the shark. I mean, it sparked a big giant shark hunt, just like in the movie, but The Blob. Many of you watching this may be too young to remember The Blob, but and these days y'all wouldn't be scared of it. Well, unless it got out of control like in the movie. But it's actually based on a real event. In 1950, a Philadelphia cop saw a purple blob fall from the sky. Not that big around. They don't know what it was. He called some other cops. They poked it with a stick. It broke up and evaporated. Don't know what it was. Many people know that the Texas Chainsaw Massacre and Psycho, bonus there, are both based on the same serial killer Ed Gein. Kind of a weird guy. You can look that one up. The Shining. And the reason I'm doing this is to establish these epic movies that we grew up watching and we're like, oh, what they're based off of. But nobody ever goes, hey, that didn't really happen. They take it for entertainment value. The Shining was based on Stephen King had actually stayed in the Stanley Hotel where The Shining is filmed. And he had a nightmare. The nightmare was a fire hose chasing his son down a hallway. That's what The Shining's based on. The whole book is off that nightmare. The Exorcist, my all-time favorite horror film. It's not that it's that good. There's some cheesy stuff in it, but I love, love, love that movie. Still to this day. It's based on a true story. However, it's based off of a 13-year-old boy who is simply known as Roland Doe. There's another name in some other accounts, but the Catholic Church has sealed these up and deny that an exorcism was performed on this boy. There's different theories on why he became the way he did. I keep saying, and I don't normally do that. Anyways, that he became despondent after his favorite aunt had died, or depending where you live, aunt had died. So there's actual, and we don't know what actually happened, but the priest kept records, documented what was going on, but they're sealed, and now they say, oh, no, it wasn't that at all. The exorcism of Emily Rose, that's also based on a true story. The real girl, her name was Elise Michael. They're not sure why she got the way she was, but everybody's like, oh, she's possessed. So after doing the rites of performing the exorcism, she actually died of starvation and malnutrition. Unlike in the movie, she didn't die from injuries, she starved to death, in which the priest and her parents were all held accountable. So, that's a good thing. But that's what the movie's based on. See, it's based. I can't wait for Rocket Man to come out because I love Elton John. I'm a huge Elton John fan. Bohemian Rhapsody, loved it. And I know, again, as I've been saying, it's not 100% accurate. You know, they rearranged some things. They're having to make a movie to entertain the masses. The Dirt, there's a bunch of stuff in it not right. And there's different reasons for doing it. Some is the honest facts really are kind of boring. I don't mean not with Motley Crue. But there's a whole bunch of blah, blah time during their career that's just nothing. I mean, you don't realize a lot of times just how much time goes in between major announcements of celebrities that we see. I mean, that's why, like, on Facebook, people will post, like, the most recent one I saw, Doris Roberts died. People jumped on this person. Yeah, 3 years ago. Why do that? Just let it go. But nobody's up on all the debt. Well, I mean, most people aren't up on all the debt. So they see someone, an announcement or a little clip or whatever the hell, and they think, oh, my God, someone I liked watching died. They don't realize it's been 3 years since the whole world was saying, oh, Betty Jo Bucktooth died. So, they have to do that. Plus, the story has to move along. And, most importantly, it needs to be enduring and entertaining. It has to get emotions from people. As a whole, us fans, with The Dirt, for example, Motley Crue fans, number one, we know all the BS that's in it that's just not right. But we know a lot of messed up stuff, and we accept that. But they're releasing this movie to everyone, not just Motley fans. Everyone. So they had to change some stuff up to make it more enduring, get emotions. You know, they toned down Vince's car accident, and when I was doing my research for this and getting video clips and stuff, I was going to do a segment on that, but for several reasons I chose not to. Number one, Vince Neil is not my favorite member of the band. He's not my most unfavorite. That spot belongs to Tommy Lee, or my least favorite. That spot belongs to Tommy Lee. But I just didn't want to dedicate that much time and attention to that. However, I will point out that, they kind of make Vince, it was an accident. And it was an accident, but he was drunk. And not just a little drunk. Drunk. And you know what? It didn't stop him. He's constantly getting busted for DWI.
A week after saying he was sober, Motley Crue singer Vince Neil was arrested on drunken driving charges.
Clematis bar owner Vince Neil is out of jail tonight following a DUI arrest overnight near the Las Vegas Strip.
It just goes on and on. When you're that rich and you're that drunk, how about get someone to drive you? There's limo services. You've got a truckload of money. Why take the chance of killing somebody? Again. So, they made and it's one of my favorite segments in the movie. They made the whole daddy Skyler thing. Real emotional and touching. And as a father and a grandfather, yeah, I get that. So that part touched me. No, I didn't cry. It was just emotional and moving to try to imagine being in that spot. But that's not really how that went down. The biggest thing on, or the best example I have for reality and what's more entertaining for the masses will be in this. I'm going to show you the clip from The Dirt when the band got back together and started talking.
Hey, man. Just want to talk, Vinny. That's it. Come on, Vinny.
Let's talk.
I was scared. After what happened with Razzle, I was scared that I was losing the only thing that ever mattered to me.
Hey, your band.
No. No, this. This. Look, we went to war together. Shit changes, people change, but I don't fucking care if Motley Crue never plays another note. All I want is my fucking brother back. Because this is the only family that I've ever known.
So how do we deal with them?
Well, you gotta get everybody in a room, for one thing.
That you guys know better than anyone. If Vince and Tommy really want to do Motley Crue, Motley Crue's gonna happen.
But I'm just telling you that this thing cannot be just about me and Tommy. I mean, we've had our differences. I still love you to death, and you know that. But we do have our differences. But this whole thing can't be just about me and Tommy getting along. We all gotta get along. Everybody has issues in this whole band. There's four people. It zigzags and zigzags around. So then where do we go next from here? I mean, obviously, there's got to be a commitment. Because if it's not, if there's people kind of hee-haw going, then
I'm here because I wanted to do this. I'm in.
Tom, what do you think?
I wasn't really planning on making this decision today. I just kind of wanted to come here and talk. And
I'm not asking you to make a decision. I'm saying, what do you just think? What do you just think about the whole thing? I mean, I don't think anybody's going to make a decision right this second.
Yeah. To tell you the truth, I don't get real excited about going around playing the same old songs again that I played for 20 years with you guys. I just don't.
No one's gonna do this if it's gonna be this.
Yeah.
I gotta do this for the next 2 years.
Hi, Virgil. I gotta get out of here. I will talk.
So there's the reality of the meeting. Now, what do you think makes for a better movie? Exactly. Now, nobody wants to see that, but that's the reality of what happened. You know, they made Tommy look excited to see Mick after the operation, after he got his hip replaced. I just so happen to have clips of that, too. Movie?
Filthy bastards.
How's that new hip?
Reality.
Tripping, man. I was like, whoa. Fuck, he's really skinny. Like scared me. Like, I started shaking a little bit.
So, see, a biopic is just based on a real story. And as I showed you with Jaws or The Blob, the Blob's the simplest one of all, or Shining. The Shining's pretty simple too. Stephen King had a nightmare and made a movie out of it. But The Blob's a blob of purple stuff fell out of the sky. Nobody knew what it was. It didn't eat people. If you haven't ever seen the movie, it's really stupid. Now, but as a little kid, look at it and see what it grew into. So, on these biopics that are coming out, they're for our entertainment. It's to give us a little peek behind the curtain at maybe some of the stuff our heroes or the celebrities that we really like, what they're like in real life or what they've gone through. It's not a documentary. There's plenty of documentaries out there. Feel free to watch those. know, they're here on YouTube. I watch them all the time. So I told you this episode was based on a true story. I told you what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 movies, biopics. They're all based on true stories. That's how I justify this being based on a true story. I do appreciate you being here. If you enjoyed it, please hit that subscribe button. The main, most important part is that you're here watching. I really appreciate that. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. Oh, one more thing before I go. For those of you that are a little edgier and have a little bit thicker skin, be sure to check out my 6 minutes page where I'm uncensored. I don't do it quite as user-friendly as this one. I really appreciate it if you check it out. Or if you know some friends that are more hardcore, not so easily butthurt, send them all over there. Until next time, have a great day. Make someone laugh.